Coming up, we talk with the University of Miami and how they're using Microsoft Azure. We'll also show you how with Microsoft Learn, you can build your own skills going forward. Stay tuned. Thanks for joining us on Customer Tech Talks. I'm your host, Ben Walters, and today we're talking with the University of Miami, who made a decision to move their infrastructure and services to Azure. Before we bring them on and have a look at their story, let's check out the video.
The University of Miami is a private university. Our mission statement is that we transform lives through teaching, research, and service. The IT needs of the University of Miami are really just to be able to be prepared and nimble for anything that comes our way. We have to be able to provide services to not only researchers and professors, but also the corporate arm of the university when it comes to IT deploying new services. Microsoft really provides us with a platform that we use to provide services to the university as a whole, whether it's Azure or any kind of operating system that we need on-prem, as well as our Office 365 implementation.
I'm joined by Marty Lovo, Director of IT and Cloud Infrastructure Services, and Michael Lecuona, Systems Architect from the University of Miami. Marty, Michael, thank you for taking the time with us.
Thank you for having us today.
Yes, thank you for having us.
Now, your use of Microsoft Azure today is pretty extensive, from ADFS to infrastructure, PaaS services, and even Power Apps. Marty, can you take us all the way back to the start and share what initially drove this move to Azure?
Sure. We wanted to make sure communication with the public was not hindered should we lose connectivity on campus. So our first project on Azure was our public website. This effort quickly grew to authentication and other critical applications, but that was really only the impetus of our move to Azure.
So it's safe to say that a desire for greater resiliency was really key in driving this move to Azure, especially considered, you know, the University of Miami being located in Hurricane Alley. Now, have you ever had an incident or an example of an incident on campus that's caused an outage?
Definitely. Our focus is to ensure we are resilient and able to sustain not only a massive hurricane, but any other situation that may cause an outage for us on campus. One outage we experienced in the beginning of our move to Azure was a transformer fire that caused our campus and data center to lose power, ultimately draining our reserves. This made us realize that while we had many critical functions in the cloud, we still had dependencies on-prem. We quickly established a plan to move or replicate those dependencies so a similar outage would not affect us.
So obviously not the most ideal way to find this out, but it sounds like there was a silver lining to this outage, which really helped to highlight the parts of your infrastructure that still had to be addressed. Now, there have been some other benefits that you've realized as well since moving to Azure. Michael, as the system architect for University of Miami, can you share some of the details here?
So our presence in Azure has given us the opportunity to offer solutions with less financial investment, as well as improved performance and scalability. We've had numerous requests for virtual machines that were needed as a POC on a temporary basis that had software that required GPUs. Our on-premise environment was and still is incapable of satisfying that kind of request. Azure gave us the capability of being able to fulfill those requests without making a large investment on GPU infrastructure on our on-premise environment. We also released a public-facing website that was experiencing too much traffic for the VMs that they were on to handle. So we're able to quickly move the site from a VM to an app service plan, and that automatically scales, and we never had another problem with it.
That's really great to see, and awesome to hear that you could take advantage of those services up front without having to do all of that heavy infrastructure layout. Now, your use of Azure has evolved over time, as has Azure itself, especially with regards to things like high availability and resiliency. Can you share how both of these evolutions together have changed the way you build things like high availability into your services going forward?
Definitely. When we first started with the cloud, our main concern was to ensure that we had enough VMs to handle an expected load or unexpected outages. But now we look to utilize PaaS solutions to ensure that we have availability and scalability to handle these unexpected elements that we can't with traditional VMs. But when we do deploy VMs, when we first started, we only had the option of availability sets. But now we have availability zones that have been introduced, and we make sure that we deploy across zones to be able to handle an outage in one zone and another will pick it up.
Really, really great to hear, and awesome to hear that you're continuing to move those services forward as the Azure offerings evolve as well. Now, the University of Miami has been on this journey for a while, so I suspect there are probably a plethora of lessons you can share with people. Marty, we might start with you. What are some of the key things that you'd share with others who are out there either just starting their journey or maybe already down that road that you would tell them to think about?
I would say be patient and be ready to never stop learning. Microsoft's always adding new services, tools, and features to the Azure platform. One day something may not exist, and the next day it's just there. Also, establishing governance process for your environment in the beginning is critical to ensure policies are being met and funds are being used appropriately. Azure has grown to include many features that allow organizations to do this natively. The earlier you adopt these guardrails, the less headaches you have later on.
Really great. And I can't stress enough how much things like governance can, you know, take a little bit of time at the start, but will pay dividends in the future as well. Michael, what about from your perspective? What are some of the lessons you'd share?
Well, I mean, I completely agree with everything that Marty said, but I'd also like to add to not be afraid of moving to the cloud. You're going to have to adopt new ways of looking at costs, how you deploy solutions, and how you manage your environment. But for all these changes, you're going to find that it's worth it. In the end, you'll see that operating on-prem or in a colo is going to work out to be either comparable or more expensive than what you would in Azure. But you will end up with solutions that have greater availability, more scalability, and are more secure. You're also going to develop skills for your team to think outside of the box in the way they design their solutions.
Some really, really great advice there, and definitely something I think everyone can learn from. Thank you so much. It's been great to hear about the University of Miami's journey and how far you've come over the past couple of years working with Azure.
Thank you for giving us the opportunity to share our cloud story.
I appreciate you having us. Thank you.
And of course, if you'd like to learn more about migrating to Azure or the well-architected framework or availability zones, you can follow the links on screen over to Microsoft Learn to get started. With modules covering everything from the fundamentals of Azure all the way through to things like developing augmented reality experiences with HoloLens. You can get certification guidance and even join in live interactive shows on Learn TV. Microsoft Learn will help you arrive at your goals faster, with more confidence, and at your own pace. Of course, if you have your own story you'd like to share on an upcoming episode of Customer Tech Talks, you can reach out to us at cttalk@microsoft.com to get started. And don't forget to follow us on Twitter and LinkedIn so that you can catch all of the latest episodes. Thanks for watching, and we look forward to seeing you on the next Customer Tech Talks.